Yes, okay, students. So let us start our class. See, students, in previous class, we are discussing about the objective problems of electric charges and field. And we are at the 13th problem. Okay? Yes. Yes, students, see question number 13th, Nana. See, what they have given is, what they have given is, let rho of r is equal to capital Q small r divided by pi r power 4 be the charge density distribution for a solid sphere of radius capital R and a total charge capital Q. Okay, for a point P inside the sphere at a distance of small r1 from the center of the sphere, magnitude of electric field is. Yes, students, JE students and NEET students, see this type of questions you need to do. Yeah. See, they have given that here there is a solid sphere. Okay, and this solid sphere is having a radius capital R, and this is the center. And on this, a charge Q is, capital Q is uniformly distributed over its sphere. And for this charge, they have given volume charge density, rho value they have given, that is Q small r divided by pi capital R power 4. Okay, and what they're asking is, and inside this solid sphere, let us imagine at this point P, which is at a distance of R1, what will be the electric field they're asking? Yes, we're going to solve this question by using Gauss law. Now, what is Gauss law? Surface integral of electric field over a Gaussian surface is equal to 1 by epsilon naught times of charge enclosed within the surface. Yes. See, students, first what we need to do is we need to find this value. How much charge is enclosed within the Gaussian surface? Gaussian surface we need to consider first. So where we have to consider the Gaussian surface? Students, where you want the electric field, at that point you consider a Gaussian surface, and this Gaussian surface is to be spherical surface. See these red dotted points. This is a Gaussian surface. Now in this Gaussian surface, let us suppose here a charge Q is there in that. How much charge dQ charge? Q inside is dQ. Q inside is dQ, let us call. And the dQ is written for a volume charge density as rho into dV. Clear, students? Yes. Okay. Now, what is rho value given for us? Is capital Q small r divided by pi r power 4. Yes. This is the rho value given for us. And this point P is at a distance of r1. So, that's why I take this r as r1. I hope you understand. Now, dV value what? dV value we need to write. Yes. What is the volume of this small Gaussian spherical surface? This is solid spherical surface. Volume is 4 by 3 pi small r cube, and small r is r1 distance. Clear, students? Yes. Now, what you will get? See, pi will get cancelled. Okay, students? Yes. You will get capital Q small r 1 power 4 divided by 3 capital R power 4. Yes, this is dQ value. Now apply here, you will get surface integral. Integration is on this Gaussian surface is equal. So you will get out of the integration, surface integral of dS is equal to Q inside is Q small r on power 4 divided by 3 R power 4 divided by epsilon naught. Clear, students? Yes, this is Q in divided by epsilon naught. Yeah. So E into, what is the surface integration of this solid sphere is 4 pi small r square. Are you getting? Yes. Only surface we want, surface area we want. 4 pi small r power 4 is equal to Q small r 1 power 4 divided by 3 epsilon naught will go up into r power 4. Got it? Yes. See, small r power 4, small r power 4 cancel. Clear, students? Yes. And here 4 is there, no? Yeah, here 4 is there. I need to write. I forgot. SR4 is there. SR4 is there. This four also gets cancelled. What you will get? Electric field E is equal to Q, okay, divided by pi will come this side. You get 3 pi epsilon naught capital R power 4. Yes, option is there. Your small mistake, students. You see, this is R square, no? Yeah, sorry. See, students, this R square, no? Surface area, 4 pi R square. So R 4, 4 cancel, R 1 power 4 cancel, get R square, R 1 square. This here R 1 square is there. Okay, yes, this is the electric field. Yes, option is there. Once you see that Q small R 4, small R 1 square by 3 pi epsilon naught R 4, 4. Yes, option C is the right answer. Yes, I'll explain. So this is a solid sphere whose volume charge density rho is given. Now on this, a Q, capital Q, is distributed uniformly. Now at inside point, which is a distance of R1, what is electric field we want? Okay, what I am doing is I am using Gauss law. Okay, surface integral of electric field over a closed surface is equal to 1 by epsilon naught times of charge enclosed within the surface. So let us find this Q inside. How much Q inside? I am calling it as dQ, and dQ for a volume charge density is written as rho into dV. Clear na? Rho value, what they have given, that I have substituted here, because at a distance of R1 I want, so that's why R1 I have placed here in the place of small r. Clear? Now what is dV? This Gaussian volume surface volume, how much is 4 by 3 pi capital R small r 1 power 3. Pi pi gets cancelled. You will get 4 capital Q R 1 power 4 divided by 3 capital R power 4. Okay, this is Q inside divided by epsilon naught. Yes, divided by epsilon naught habitat is equal to E into surface integration of ds. Now what is the surface integral of this ds? This ds how much is 4 pi small r 1 power small r1 square, 4 pi r square, r is small r1. Okay, yes, 4 4 cancel, r1 square here, r1 square cancel, you will get one more r1 square here. Okay, now how pi will come down? So what will get? Capital Q small r1 square divided by 3 pi epsilon naught r power 4. Yes, this is the answer, and that is option 3, C is right answer. I hope you understand it clearly. Okay, next question. Let us see next question. Yes, see students, 14th question, observe carefully, it is important. Yes, 14th question, Nana. Yes, see students, what they are given? A charged ball capital B hangs from a seat thread S, which makes angle theta with the large charge conducting sheet. See, this is a conducting sheet they have given. This is a conducting sheet, and P as shown in figure. The surface charge density of this sheet is proportional to S. So sigma of this sheet is proportional to what they are asking. This is their question. Yes, students, I told you that due to a charge sheet, conducting charge sheet, electric field at any point is given as sigma by epsilon naught. Do you remember this? If only sheet is there, due to a charge sheet, electric field at any point is sigma by 2 epsilon naught. And for conducting sheet, electric field is given as sigma by epsilon naught only. Okay, now so this electric field from this positive charge, the electric field will be in this direction. Are you getting? Yes. Now on this ball B, one force is acting. Imagine this is a ball B. On this, let us imagine this ball having some charge Q, and it is placed in electric field. So electric field is in this direction. Now on this charge, a force will act, that is Q into electric field, as you know. And this is suspended from a fixed support in this direction. So with the vertical, it is making some angle theta. Clear? And one more force is acting on it, that is mg. Mg is acting down, as you know. Clear? Yes. Now the question is, the surface charge density of this is proportional to what? Okay,
Yes, students, see here, let us imagine in this thread a tension T is produced. Now this tension T can be resolved into two components. Clear? Here one more vertical, dotted vertical I have drawn. If this is theta, means this is also theta. Clear? Now this theta can be resolved into two components. One is T cos theta here, and another one is T sin theta in this direction. T sin theta. Clear, students? Yes. Now you can write, here I write T sin theta is equal to QE, then only it will be hanging in this position. And T cos theta should be equal to MG. Clear? Then only it can be in here. Okay? Now, if you divide these two equations, vertically I have, horizontally I have equated, vertically also I have equated. Now divide these equations, T, T cancel. You will get sin theta by cos theta is nothing but tan theta. So tan theta can be written as Q into E divided by MG. Okay, then what will be E, Nana? E can be written as MG by Q tan theta. Are you getting? Yes. Now, as you know, electric field due to a charge sheet, conducting sheet is given as sigma by epsilon naught. So in the place of E, I'll write sigma by epsilon naught is equal to MG divided by Q tan theta. Now we want only sigma. Sigma is equal to MG epsilon naught divided by Q tan theta. Clear, students? Now see, mass of the ball is constant, acceleration due to gravity is constant, epsilon naught because it is placed in air is also constant, and charge on the ball also constant. So everything is constant. We can write sigma is proportional to tan theta. Yes, this is only what we want. Clear? Yes. So option D is right answer. Option D is right answer. Got it, students? Okay. Yes, option D is right answer. Next, let us go to next question. Yes. See, students, question number 15, Nana. Okay? Yes. So 14th question we have solved. Now 15th question. Let us take. See here, what they have given is a charge 10 microcoulomb is placed at the center of a hemisphere of radius 10 centimeter. As shown in figure, the electric flux through hemisphere is, see students, let us imagine this is a total sphere having radius capital R. Okay, and at the center, let us suppose a charge Q is placed. Then how much flux is coming through this sphere? According to Gauss law, flux coming through this sphere can be written as I is equal to Q upon epsilon naught. Q is the charge within this sphere. Now the question is, due to hemisphere, means only half sphere, let us say. From this spot, how much flux is coming? Yes, half of the total flux. Is that is nothing but Q by 2 epsilon naught. Did you got the point what I am saying? From hot or half part of the total sphere, how much flux is coming? Half of this total flux. Yes. But charge given, how much given? 10 microcoulomb. Yes. 10 micro. Micro means 10 to the power of minus 6 divided by 2 into epsilon naught value 8.854. Okay. 8.854 into 10 to the power of minus 12. Clear, students? Yes. So if you divide these two, you will get the answer. That is 0.56. Do calculations. 0.56 into 10 to the power of plus 6. Minus 12 going to this side, it will become plus 12. And minus 6 plus 12 is plus 6. Okay? Yes. And answer flux is Newton meters per coulomb. And it can be around equal to 0.6 into 10 to the power of 6. Newton meter square per coulomb. Clear? Yes. And it can be written as 6 into 10 to the power of 5 Newton meter square per coulomb. Yes, this will be the answer. As you know, flux does not depend upon size and shape of the Gaussian surface. It is not required. Okay. Yes. Option is there. Yes. Option 6. C is right answer. 16 into 10 to the power of 5 newton meter square per coulomb. MKS unit means SI unit only. Clear?
Yes.
This is the answer. Next.
Let us go to next question.
16th question, Nana. Now, what they are given? 2 point torches. 10 to the power of minus 7 coulomb and minus 10 to the power of minus 7 coulomb. Both are equal in magnitude, opposite in direction. Sorry, opposite in nature. Are placed at A and B 20 centimeter apart as shown in figure. Yes, here and here they have placed. Means it will form a dipole, as you know. Okay. Now calculate electric field at point C. Yes, point C, here at point C, which is at distance of 20 centimeter from both A and B. From A 20 centimeter, from B also 20 centimeter. Then calculate the electric field at that point. Yes, you can do this one by two methods. One is principle of superposition, another one is by direct formula. Whatever you want, you can do. Okay, direct formula if you want. See students, let us suppose here a dipole is there, negative charge and positive charge. Okay, and this distance is, let us imagine 2a. Okay, and here at a distance of x on its equatorial line, what will be the electric field? Electric field here is given as E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught P bar divided by A square plus X square whole power 3 by 2. This is the formula you can get. Okay. If you want with the direction, you will get negative sign here, as you know. Okay. It's only magnitude you want. Okay. No problem. Now here X is from the center of a dipole, but 20 centimeter they are given from A and B. So directly 20 centimeter if you substitute in the place of X equal to 20 centimeter if you substitute, you will get a wrong answer. Okay, what you need to do, this is totally 20 centimeter given. This total is 20 centimeter given, Nana. And this is also 20 centimeter given. Means this will be 10 centimeter. This is 20 centimeter. Okay, this you need to calculate first. Rectangle triangle you apply. Okay, there is 20 square is equal to 10 square plus x square. 400 is equal to 100 plus x square. So x square is equal to 300. You got x square value. Now you can substitute. Got it? Yes, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught is 9 into 10 to the power of 9 nana into P. What is P? P is nothing but any one of the charge into total length. Okay, yes. Any one of the charges, how much given? 10 to the power of minus 7 into total length is how much given? Distance between them is 20 centimeter given. Yes, 20 centimeter. 20. Clear? Centimeter. Okay. Centimeter convert into meters. It is 10 to the power of minus 2 is equal to 20 into 10 to the power of minus 9. Yes, 20 into 10 to the power of minus 9.
Dear students, is divided by
a distance. A value must be 10 centimeter. Okay, everything is running in centimeter. Remember, okay, yes, 10 square plus x square value 300 whole power 3 by 2. Yes, downside it is running in centimeters. Remember, okay, we get 9 into 10 to the power of 9 plus 9, it will get cancelled. So you will have 9 into 20 divided by 10 square is 100. 100 plus 300 is 400. 400 whole power 3 by 2. Clear? Yes, is equal to 9 into 20 is nothing but 180 divided by 400 root of whole power 3 by 2. Means it can be written as 20 power 3. Clear, students? Yes. 400 under root gives you 20. 20 power 3. Okay. So 180 divided by 20 power 3 means 2 multiply with 3 times. 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8. 8 3 zeros into it is running in centimeters. Nana. So centimeter power 3. Centimeter power 3. 1 centimeter is 10 to the power of minus 2 meters. 4 power 3 is nothing but 10 to the power of minus 6. So 10 to the power of minus 6. Clear, students? A 0, 0 cancel. You will get 18 divided by 800 into 10 to the power of minus 6. Okay? Yes. So, what you will get the answer is 2.2
into 10 to the power of plus 4 minus 6 going to upside. Okay. Newton per coulomb. Yes. Option B. You check option B. 2.2 into 10 to the power of 4 Newton per coulomb. Calculate this. You will get the answer. Got it? You can do with this method or otherwise. Principle of superposition. How to do? Due to this charge at this point, electric field is in this direction. Calculate that value. And due to this, sorry, this first charge, no, yes, electric field is in this direction. And due to negative charge, electric field is in this direction. I hope you will get the same electric field. Both the magnitudes are same. Now resolve into components. Horizontal components you need to add. You will get the answer. Okay, this is another method. Whichever method is easy for you, then you follow. Okay, option B is the right answer for 16th question. Clear, students? Yes. Now we are moving on to 17th question. See question number 17, Nana. Yes, students, question number 17. See, they are given the electric field due to infinitely long, straight, uniformly charged wire at a distance of small r is directly proportional to. Yes, due to a long, straight, uniformly charged wire, electric field at a distance r is given as E is equal to lambda by 2 pi epsilon naught into r. So electric field is proportional to what? 1 by r. As lambda 2 pi epsilon naught constant. So electric field is proportional to 1 by r. So option C is right answer. Nana. Direct question, formula based question. Okay, next question number 18. See, there is a point charge small q is located at the center of a cube. At the center of a cube, yes, I am drawing a cube. Yes, this is a cube. So, at the center of a cube, a charge q is located. Let us suppose. Okay, now. Their question is, what is the electric flux of this point charge through a face of the cube? Now, what is the flux through total cube? Flux can be given as q by epsilon naught according to Gauss law. Now, question is, through any one face, how many faces will be there for a cube? 6 faces will be there. Through any one face, flux will be total flux divided by 6. That is nothing but q by 6 epsilon naught. Got it? Through one face. This through any one phase of a cube, flux will be q by 6 epsilon naught. So yes, option B is right answer. Clear? It is also a direct question. Already this point we have discussed when we are discussing in class. Okay, yes, next question number 19. Students, question number 19, Nana. Yes, see that question. See, they are given an electron initially at rest falls a distance of 1.5 centimeter in a uniform electric field of magnitude 2 into 10 to the power of 4 Newton per coulomb. Okay, the time taken by the electron to fall this distance is this. How much distance electron is falling? Let us imagine h. I am calling that is 1.5 centimeter. And which is falling in an electric field of magnitude of 2 into 10 to the power of 4 Newton per coulomb. Okay, 1.5 can be written as 1.5 into 10 to the power of minus 2 meters because we need to write SI units from the always. Okay, now how much time it will take to fall through this distance? Imagine a situation like this. Imagine an electron is falling downwards. From what height? From height h. Clear? And this electron is not falling in gravity. It is falling under electric field. Let us suppose electric field is in this direction. Now force on the electron will be in this direction, as you know. Because it is electron, negative charge particle, in negative charge particle, electric field will be, sorry, force will be in opposite direction to electric field. So in this direction, force is acting. First, you calculate how much force is acting. Force acting is nothing but QE. It is electron, so small e into capital E. Now, as you know, force can be written as ma. So ma is equal to e. We can write e is the charge of electron. And what will be the acceleration it is getting? E by m. Clear, students? Yes. Now it is moving under an acceleration. Clear? Vertical acceleration. So we need a time. See, initially it is at rest. They have given electron initially at rest. U is zero. Now you are having U value, distance how much it is traveling, and acceleration. You can use S is equal to UT plus half A T square. S value is 1.5 into 10 to the power of minus 2 is equal to U value 0. So everything 0 plus half into A value EE by M into T square. Clear, students? Yes, this I'll write H so that you will understand. Is H. So T square can be written as 2HM. I am sending that set divided by EE. Then T can be written as under root of 2HM divided by EE. Now you know H value, you know mass of electron. What is mass of electron? 9.1 into 10 to the power of minus 31 kg. Substitute. E value you know, charge of electron is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulomb. Substitute. And capital E value, however, they are given. If you calculate these all things, you will get the answer 2.9. You will get around 2.9 into 10 to the power of minus 9 seconds. Calculate this, Nana. You need to do calculations. That's it.
I hope you understand the process what I have given for you. Okay. So these all things, this formula, you should get quickly. Now you need to spend time to calculate these values only. Clear? Got it, students? Yes. Next question. Question number 20. See what they have given. A conducting sphere. Point is important. It is a conducting sphere, students. Remember. A conducting sphere of radius 10 centimeter has an unknown charge. We don't know how much it is. If the electric field at a distance of 20 centimeter from the center of the sphere is given, electric field is given where 20 centimeter from the center of the sphere is given, and which is pointing radially outward, then net charge on the sphere is how much? Imagine here, sphere is there, and on this sphere a charge Q is there, and which is having a radius 10 centimeter. Now at outside a point, electric field they have given. Then what will be the charge they are asking? As you know, for a conducting sphere for outside point, electric field is given as KQ by R square only. Clear? Yes. Q value we need to find. E value they have given. E value given out to be 1.2 into 10 to the power of 3 SI unit given, Newton per coulomb. And R value also given. R value also given, Anna? R value they have given it as 20 centimeters. 20 centimeter is nothing but 20 into 10 to the power of minus 2 meters. Substitute, you get the answer. E value 1.2 into 10 to the power of 3 is equal to K value 9 into 10 to the power of 9 into Q you need to find divided by R is 20 into 10 to the power of minus 2. Yes. We can write 20 into 10 to the power of minus 2. We can write it as 20 divided by 100, no? Yes. It is 0.2. Or otherwise, write like this only. 20 into 10 to the power of minus 2 whole square it is. So, yes. You will get 6 here. Clear? Yes. 9. Again, 3 threes are 9. 3 0.4s are 12. Okay? Yes, 0.4 is equal to 3 Q divided by 20 square is nothing but 400 into 10 to the power of minus 2 whole square, 10 to the power of minus 4. Yes. So what you will get? You will get 0.4 into 400 into 10 to the power of minus 4 divided by 3 is equal to Q. Clear, students? Yes. Yes, it is 4. 4 is 16. And 10 is removed because of this. This will become 4. Okay. Yes, 10 is removed because of this. Clear? Yes, Elliot. 4 is 16. 16 by 3 into 10 to the power of minus 3 is equal to Q. 10 to the power of minus 3 can be written as milli. Okay. Now see options. It can be written as 16 divided by 3. How much? 16 divided by 3 can be written as 3 5s are 15. 1 is there. Point if you keep 10, you will get
3 3 is 9. It is around 5.3. So you will get Q is equal to 5.3 into 10 to the power of yes. Sorry. Ah, 10 to the power of minus 3. Yeah. One more thing, 10 to the power of minus 6 also is there, no? It will go into that side, you will become 10 to the power of divided by 10 to the power of minus 6 is there here. Okay.
Wait. This is not looking. This is not appearing. Oh, what is happening to this? What to be done now?
Okay, students, it is not coming, so I think I need to go back. 1 minute, wait. Okay, let it be. I think so. You know the question. So it is coming now.
To do for this now.
Wait, we can like this. Okay, so let us give the value only here. Yeah, students, where is the question? Yes, question number it is. Okay, students, from here onwards, we'll continue in next class. Otherwise, I'll make it record and I'll send you in WhatsApp or YouTube. Okay. And one more thing, students, listen. On Friday, I'll take subjective exam on this chapter. And on Saturday, I'll take objective exam. Nana. Okay. So inform to all the students and I'll send one WhatsApp message also for you. Okay, na? So Friday is subjective exam and Saturday is objective exam on this topic, on this chapter. Yes. Okay, students. So we will continue in next class. Bye.